I'm the only person I know with the first name Duplessis. I'm named after Mornay Duplessis. He used to play eight for South Africa back in the days. Dad played a bit of footy back in his day and ran into him a few times, and I think they just became pretty good mates off the field. When Dad sets his mind on something, pretty much like me, it just happens, so my mum didn't have a say in it, I don't think. It's pretty crack up. We're at Red Rocks at the southern end of Wellington. I love coming here, watching the waves, going for a walk. In the evening, the sun sets over there, which is really nice, and you can end up seeing the South Island across the Cook Strait. Grew up in Taranaki, New Plymouth. I used to play halfback when I was at school. Yeah, I don't know why. Just thought I could pass and kick, probably, but I think as I grew up, I liked the look of ruck more than anything. Coaches always have me on, eh? They reckon if our halfbacks go down, I'll be jumping on the field at halfback, but yeah, I hope not. Probably not the biggest open side flanker there is going around, but I don't know, I'd make up for it with how hard I work and my passion, I guess. Growing up, definitely wanted to be a Hurricane. Super Rugby debut was in Manly in Sydney in Australia. We played at the Brookvale Oval in round one. Like, we were lucky enough to get the win, 1-point win against a good Waratahs side.
And they break away on debut. Duplessis Karifi, first try in Super Rugby.
For me, it was just a dream come true, you know, growing up, looking up to all these boys playing the Hurricanes. A lot of trainings and early mornings kind of coming to one point of fruition for me, so I was very happy. I love photography, eh? Like, living in Wellington, there's so much to shoot. It's quite therapeutic. Literally wherever I go, I take my camera, chuck my music in and go for a walk and hopefully take some good shots. I was lucky enough to get given a Canon 6D, but I had to learn how to use it because there's no point using automatic, it just takes away all the technical side of it. So that's been awesome, just a little bit of a hobby on the side, watching YouTube tutorials and like that. If I was to choose between landscape and people, I think I'd choose people. Like capturing emotion and real moments, I love doing that. The higher you go in rugby, the more pressure you're faced with, and I think if you've got something else to just clear your mind and focus all your energy on to just refresh, then it's good. I really enjoy it. I've learned a lot of Artie. Took me under his wing a little bit, which I'm pretty thankful for. I guess the biggest thing I've learned of him is just how to prepare for a game each week. I think I took it for granted how much work it takes to be set for a game on a Saturday. Just learning how to be a professional rugby player more than anything, really. Playing against David Pocock, it was an awesome learning experience for me. I got lippy to him at one stage and he just told me to pull my head in, which is actually good advice coming from him, and I'd like, yeah, knocked me for six. He's obviously an awesome man on and off the field. I really appreciated the opportunity to play against him. Yeah, mark of a good Lucy is just how much work he gets through, I think. At the end of the game, you're always looking at how many tackles you've made or how effective you were at the breakdown. So I guess looking at players that I've looked up to growing up, Artie and obviously Richie McCaw and stuff like that, they just work really hard. I mean, sometimes the stuff they do is unseen, but it's a really valid contribution to the team. So just work ethic, I think. Bit of mongrel.